Ay, Aníbal era alegre. Él era como yo digo, el payaso de la casa. Porque él era todo risa. Todo el mundo lo quería mucho.
Aníbal Donés Torres had asthma since he was a child.
Este era el de él y este era el mío.
At 54 years old, he knew to keep his breathing machine by his side.
Cuando había electricidad en su mismo cuarto, él conectaba la máquina. Él tenía su máquina en el cuarto y la conectaba a su receptáculo y se daba la terapia. No tenía que levantarse.
But then came Hurricane Maria and they lost power. 5 months later, the Donés family still didn't have electricity. And one night, Aníbal woke up gasping for air.
Lo primero que él me dijo, Dios mío, ayúdame.
He asked his siblings to turn on the generator so he could use his breathing machine. But at that point, he had gone too long without oxygen.
Se le veía lo desesperado que le estaba. Que se veía, que respira, es que se le veía.
Yo llamaba a mi hermana, decía, avancen, que ya mi hermana le está dando CPR, se nos va. Y llamaba gente de mi trabajo y todo para que me ayudaran con las ambulancias.
When the ambulance arrived, Aníbal had long stopped breathing.
Mi sobrina le dio esta respiración, le dio la. Ella trató de sobrevivirlo, porque ella trató. Por lo menos tratamos, hicimos lo que pudimos.
It would be another 4 months after Aníbal died before his neighborhood got the power turned back on. But even the day I met his family, 2.5 years after Hurricane Maria, the power was out yet again.
Estamos sin luz desde esta mañana.
Basically, the outages in Puerto Rico are non-existent.
José Ortiz is the CEO of Puerto Rico's Electric Power Authority, also known as PREPA. He says on a regular day, only some 400 customers will lose power.
It's a very low number.
I spoke to Ortiz in March. In May, he held a press conference with Governor Wanda Vázquez, where they reassured Puerto Ricans that the power authority is better prepared for this hurricane season. And then this happened. Ortiz explained it wasn't a power outage, but that they were using a generator and it failed.
Lo peor que puede suceder a un administrador, un gobierno, es decirle al país que estamos listos y por un incidente percatarnos que ni ellos mismos confían en su sistema eléctrico cuando estaban conectados a un generador.
Ángel Figueroa Jaramillo is the president of the union that represents PREPA workers. He says Puerto Rico's power grid is still vulnerable.
Desde María hasta este momento, los trabajos de mantenimiento, los trabajos de mejora del sistema eléctrico prácticamente han sido muy pocos. Muy pocos.
In response to Figueroa Jaramillo's claim, PREPA's leadership told us the agency spent $100 million during the last fiscal year on maintenance. But that's only a fraction of the more than $2 billion PREPA awarded in contracts for a diverse range of services during the same period. NBCLX and our reporting partner HuffPost analyzed PREPA's list of contracts in recent years. We found that since Hurricane Maria, the Power Authority has awarded $4.4 billion in contracts for services like consulting, hurricane reconstruction, and natural gas. The majority of the money, $3.7 billion, has been awarded to U.S. companies.
It's important to note PREPA was already some $9 billion in debt before the hurricane and before these contracts were awarded. But the president of the union says when there's work needed on the grid, PREPA favors private companies over local workers, even when it's more expensive.
Nosotros hemos presentado, Bianca, a la gobernadora y la última administración es propuestas que son económicamente hablando mucho menos costosas que estas compañías privadas, detalladas por renglones. No es una propuesta hipotética meramente, sino vamos por renglones cuánto cuesta. Y lamentablemente hemos caído en oídos sordos.
One contract reveals PREPA agreed to pay a Florida-based company more than $400 per street light they repaired, while the union proposed to do it for a little more than $60 each.
Lo que yo creo que Estados Unidos está viendo a Puerto Rico es como una base de negocio, de perpetuarse en sus ganancias a costa del pueblo de Puerto Rico.
The single largest contract PREPA has awarded since Hurricane Maria went to New Fortress Energy for $1.5 billion. The company, whose founder and CEO is billionaire Wes Edens, was supposed to start delivering natural gas to San Juan in June 2019, according to their agreement with PREPA. But 10 months later, when I interviewed Ortiz in March, it hadn't happened.
Pero en junio de 2019, usted estaba en la zona donde se estaba construyendo diciendo, ya vamos a tener gas natural para septiembre o octubre.
Tendría que mirar el récord, pero me parece raro que yo te lo dijera en junio o julio, cuando y 3 meses después, decir que en 3 meses después iba a estar eso prendido. O sea, yo conozco de construcción.
Nosotros esperamos ya septiembre, octubre estar, ¿verdad?, que se vea esto en la factura.
Not only did he say it, but he also promised Puerto Ricans savings on their electricity bill.
Y vamos a tener un gran ahorro.
In late May of this year, Ortiz and the governor announced the project was completed. But when we spoke to PREPA's deputy director, he told us the plant was still burning diesel instead of natural gas.
Are those stations still burning diesel?
Yes, they were burning diesel yesterday and part of this week because the natural gas provider was running additional tests. I mean, these are meant to be dual fuel facilities. So we have the ability to change between, you know, natural gas and diesel. So we don't see anything, you know, wrong in terms of, you know, burning diesel at some point in time.
So for clarity, is it burning diesel today? Will it be burning diesel for the next week or month? Or is it going to be at your discretion? How will Puerto Ricans know that it is in fact using natural gas? Because that's what the $1.5 billion contract was for.
Sure. It's natural. It's our in theory, it's at our discretion. We do have in the contract a minimum expense commitment in terms of how much, when are we going to convert to back to gas. I don't have that data with me. I can certainly make sure that you get that.
We followed up, but have yet to get an answer. And New Fortress Energy didn't respond to our multiple requests for comment. Meanwhile, there's another contract that has been raising questions. And that's the one awarded to the consulting firm of former New Jersey Governor Chris Christie for $200,000. Congresswoman Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez called it, quote, eluding in progress in a tweet. PREPA says Christie's experience securing FEMA funds after Hurricane Sandy makes him a valuable asset to help make sure Puerto Rico receives the disaster funds Congress already approved. But this is the second time PREPA has hired Christie's company. The first time was in February for $28,000 a month.
What tangible results can you show the Puerto Rican people? Maybe something that you could share with us, a report, something that we could see why it was justified to have a second contract with $200,000.
I mean, this is a team effort, and it's really difficult to point that, you know, this specific advisor or consultant achieved X, Y number of dollars for PREPA. This is a team effort. We feel that, you know, Mr. Christie, Governor Christie, is a great addition to the team, and that he certainly adds value to adding credibility to what you know, to those conversations at the DC level.
We reached out to Christie's company for comment multiple times, but didn't hear back.
For me, the question is, why is it every time something bad happens to the Puerto Rican people, some big lucrative contract is given to a political friend?
In our analysis, we found PREPA spent more than $130 million in legal and consulting services since Hurricane Maria. In that same period of time, groups have been pushing for public funds to be invested in projects like the one going on in this town. This is also a community that went some 9 months without power after Hurricane Maria, but they no longer have that problem with power outages because thanks to a grant from a nonprofit group, they were able to invest in rooftop solar panels.
The money that's gone to the consultants have produced nothing. I would suggest that the kinds of proposals that the community groups have been putting forward and that many of the solar organizations are putting forward could not have done worse than what they've done with the money.
PREPA leadership defends their use of consultants, especially in their negotiations to turn over some of the power authority's functions to private companies. Some government officials are touting that move as one that will bring reliable power to Puerto Ricans.
Tenemos todavía el cable para instalar la planta porque como la tenemos que estar utilizando a cada momento.
But almost 3 years after Hurricane Maria, many Puerto Ricans' trust in their government's promises is running low.
Nosotros, si hace una tormenta mañana, creo que estaríamos sin luz 2 años. Yo, es lo que yo creo, porque la luz no han mejorado en nada.